When you're very skinny, you bulk up. When you're fat, it's easy, you cut. But what if you're skinny fat? Being skinny fat is just like when somebody asks you if you are fat or skinny and you reply with yes-n't. You look skinny when you're wearing a shirt, but as soon as that shirt comes off, you generally just look unhealthy and a bit fat. And now this is caused by a lot of different factors, but this is mainly because of genetics, but also a bit because of your bone structure and general fat loss rules. The thing with being skinny fat is that you're not really that muscular, but you also don't really store that much fat. However, this is not really the case for your belly, and this often gives a rather unhealthy look. Even though you might have the same body fat percentage as someone else, you just have less muscle mass. And well, the fat is stored in a more concentrated area near your stomach. But no problem, my friends, today I'm going to show you exactly how I would go on about fixing this issue as fast as possible, so you can finally take off your shirt again without having to be afraid of judgment. Now before we start here, I just want to quickly point out that just like with any other transformation, you're going to have to be patient. You can't really expect to look like a Greek god in just a couple of weeks, but now without further ado, let's jump right into it. As we've assessed before, being skinny fat means you don't really have that much muscle mass, but here is where we need to pay attention, because if the same individual had more muscle mass, even though having the same body fat percentage, they would look way better. So before we are going to look at your diet, which will also be crucial by the way, first you need to start doing some weightlifting exercises. The problem is that since most people see their belly fat as well being fat, they're going to start doing a lot of cardio. That's because it generally allows you to burn off a few hundred calories extra per day, but this comes at a cost. According to this meta-analysis that looked at 21 different studies, found that generally cardio does seem to interfere with strength and muscular gains. That's because it can increase cortisol levels, causing too much stress and thus decreasing muscle mass. Now before you avoid cardio altogether, when you're doing it in different training sessions than your training days, or you're doing it less than 20 minutes, you can still do it to burn a few more extra calories, but I would definitely advise to try to stick to the lower end and do more explosive cardio instead of slow-paced one. Now this all is why a good muscle building program is going to be crucial if you want to change the way you look, because a big mistake that most of these guys make is neglecting resistance training. And this doesn't really seem fun at first, but trust me, this will change your life in a very positive way, so just get started with it. Now if you're relatively new to fitness, or you've been training less than 2 to 4 years consistently, you're going to probably even burn off some of that belly fat in the process, since it's not that uncommon for people to automatically burn more calories and burn some of that fat, since weightlifting does increase your metabolism as shown in this study. Now the important thing here is a good training program. Since there are a lot of bros out there, it's hard to find information that is accurate, so if you're completely new, you can check out this video for an at-home workout to see if it works for you, or you can invest in my at-home workout program, link in the description. But if you're already lifting in the gym, you can check out many of my other videos to make your own, or you can look into my other training program. Now because designing a good workout program is too much to take into one video, I'm going to refer you to just watch a lot of my videos, but as long as it's just not a cookie cutter program you found online by some bro science personal trainer, you should be fine. But just to quickly make some points so you're not left out confused, first off, you need to focus more on getting stronger on bigger compound lifts, since these will result in the most muscle mass gained because they use a lot more muscles. If you're only doing bicep curls, your arms might grow, but you're still going to look skinny and, well, fat. Next, focus on progressive overload. You need to become stronger at all your lifts and increase that weight over time. This also means that you want to stick to the same exercises for a certain period of time, and even the fundamentals will almost always stay the same. Now make sure to track that progress using a notebook, and you're going to see that building muscle isn't going to be as hard as it might seem. You also want to invest in smashing that like button for some future gains. But now while you're building some muscle, you're going to have to look into your diet. Even though I just said that it's not uncommon for people to lose their belly fat when they're starting with lifting, this doesn't mean you're going to neglect food altogether. The most important thing that you have to look at first when you're trying to achieve a body recomposition is the amount of calories. Since probably most of you are beginners or intermediates, you're going to want to be in a slight calorie deficit. And that's because you're going to be able to build muscle and lose fat at the same time quite easily. I also highly recommend to watch this video video because this will learn you more about it. But one of the biggest mistakes that skinny fat people make is cutting down drastically on calories, but this will only make it worse or result in the physique that they have right now. Because we know from plenty of studies that too big of a calorie deficit will result in muscle loss, mainly because you're not going to eat enough protein because of the restriction. So you're not only going to lose fat, meaning that you're also going to lose some muscle, meaning that you're just going to look skinny fat, just with a lot less mass. Now, since the average metabolic rate for men is about 2500 calories, we're going to want to eat about 100 to 250 calories less. So this brings us to roughly 2350 calories. But I definitely advise you to use this calorie calculator that I will put in the description to find out how much calories you're actually burning. Of course, it's important to track your weight and see that you don't lose that much mass, so losing about 0.5 pounds or about 0.2 kilograms of body weight per week is going to be your target. After we've got the amount of calories, it's time to look at macros: protein, fats, and carbs. A meta-analysis looking at 49 trials found that there doesn't seem to be more benefit to eating more than roughly 0.7 grams of protein per pound of body weight, or 1.6 grams per kilogram. But there isn't really much downside to eating more, and some would say that more is even better, so we are going to round it up to 0.8 grams per pound of body weight, or 1.6 per kilogram. And that's just to make sure you're eating enough of it. So let's take an individual of 80 kilograms or 176 pounds. He's going to need to eat about 128 grams of protein. Now, it's very important to eat enough protein not only for building muscle, but also for losing weight, since it has a much higher thermogenesis than carbs. And this means that to absorb protein, we're going to need to use more calories as opposed to carbs. And for most people, eating enough protein will already cause them to subconsciously eat less calories and lose fat, as we can see in this clinical trial, where 50 overweight subjects lost about 4.3 to 6.2 kilograms over 6 months. And they didn't even try to eat less than they normally would, so this is definitely going to help us in building muscle and losing fat at the same time. The next important macro to look at is the fats. Please don't neglect these, since they have a very important role in regulating hormones. So the minimum, according to our recent review, is going to be about 15 to 30% of your total calories, but more isn't necessarily worse, so we're going to stick to the middle and go with about 22.5%. So for the 2350 calories, that's going to be about 59 grams of fats. Now, the amount of carbs is just going to be the remainder of the calories, since they don't really have that much importance to our bodily processes. If we do the math, we've got about 1370 calories remaining, or about 327 grams of carbs, since 1 gram of carb equals about 4 calories. And this might seem like a lot, but we need that energy to fuel our workouts, and one clinical trial found that a high protein and carb diet will be better to maintain muscle mass. So we've got our calories and macros set up, and this is where we're going to start from. You're going to have to track your weight every week and take some progress pictures along the way, and make sure that you're losing weight but at a relatively slow pace. If you're losing weight too fast, add some calories, and if you're losing weight too slow, subtract some. It might help to keep meals about the same every week, so you don't always have to count every single calorie. Now, if you've got any suggestions or questions, make sure to drop them down in the comments below, because I will gladly answer them. And now smash that like button and subscribe button, and I'll see you guys later.